Salutations, everybody. It is Matty here today, and this week, Fallout 76 is coming out. It feels like such a short road in a way. There was that one period of time in August where it felt like forever, but now the launch has really snuck up on us with so many beta sessions. Technically, the game is already out for most of us. But anyway, Bethesda has given us somewhat of a roadmap, an idea of future content plans for Fallout 76. So I'm going to be going over it today in their launch and beyond post on Bethesda.net, which I will have linked in the description down below for you guys to read, but we're going over all of it today. So let's start off with, it's with great excitement that we're finally launching Fallout 76, a Fallout game unlike anything we've done. Really, it's a game unlike anything we've ever played. It's been our privilege and passion to build games that transport you into new worlds and new experiences. With Fallout 76, we've woven together parts of our past Fallouts, the survival genre, and massive online games to create something unique. A game where you share in the story and the struggle to survive with your friends, with strangers, and with us. A huge thanks to everyone at Bethesda and ZeniMax who supported us in making this game, creating a new style of game that is taking the best from not only our own producers, programmers, artists, and designers, but great efforts from across the company. Special thanks to our friends at ZeniMax Online, id, and Arcane who helped us. And thanks to everyone in publishing, IT, Bethesda.net, customer service, admin, and our incredible partners in QA. And a special thank you to all the fans who participated in the beta. With your help, we've made the game better each week, and this is just the beginning. We have an incredible list of updates we've begun work on, from camp building improvements, new quests and events, new vault openings, character respecking, a faction-based PvP system, and much more. We hope your journey in Fallout 76 is as fun and rewarding as it was for us to build it. We can't wait to see where the country roads take you. All our best, Bethesda Game Studios. Good letter, but let's focus on the launch and beyond content. There is one thing to note here, and this could be under the much more category, but there isn't a discussion of new areas to go to through DLC. So I do wonder about that. Is that ever going to be a possibility with this game? Because they do highlight new vault openings. So there are vaults. Once again, I'm going to bring it up for the third video. Vault 94. Completely locked down. Not sure what's going on. Seems ripe for DLC content. Friend of mine, Vault of Daedalus, made the suggestion, and I wholeheartedly agree, that this vault should open and it should add NPCs to the world, which Bethesda added here, new events and quests, they should bring those with them. It gives the world a sense of being alive, and I really think it would add to the experience, also satiate that complaint of no human NPCs. It's a real smart, natural way of doing it, making the world feel alive, like it's developed, like there is progression, like the wasteland really is starting to rebuild. Character respecking is a huge one that I think a lot of people really asked for, because as I messed around a little bit with the leveling up system, I still really like what Bethesda has here, but sometimes I just want a point in one of my special stats, but I don't want to get the perk card from said special stat, because if I open a pack and I already have an Action Boy perk card, but I already have two Action Boy perk cards ranked up together slotted under my character, I just need the point. I don't need another agility perk card. So being able to respec your character strictly off of points itself is going to be a great option for folk who want a very specific build with specific perk cards, because sometimes the system clashes with itself, despite being, in my opinion, pretty good for the type of game Fallout 76 is. A faction PvP system, that has me pretty pumped. We talked about last week how there was a data mine for Fallout 76's beta, and there was the discovery of a TDM mode, which was also confirmed by Jeff Garner in an interview with Danny O'Dwyer, so we knew something like that was coming, but faction-based is a much more exciting premise. The idea of me creating a big faction for my friends and my viewers, and people are teaming up and fighting against other factions, that's the other thing that's going to give this wasteland an identity, because you have all these various factions already in the wasteland, like the Responders, there's the Brotherhood of Steel, the Enclave, the list goes on, but they feel like remnants. So the factions that are alive are going to be the other players. I think it feeds off the idea of what Fallout 76 is all about and can actually add to the game rather than taking away from what we love about it. Especially if Bethesda has a ranking system of some kind, and let's say the top three factions of the month get some form of items based off their logos and designs for said faction. It really brings the world to life, where now items are created in universe because that faction has so much power and so much dominance over the wasteland. It's just food for thought. I don't think they're going to go that far with it, but still, I think it's something that could really build off what Bethesda seems to be looking at here, which is how do we take this wasteland, which feels very desolate, the only life here is the players, and build upon that. Camp building improvements. I liked the camp system in this game. It was one of the few things that I messed around with in Fallout 76 where I thought, yeah, I don't think this needs any changes. I thought the UI received huge improvements where it was easy to find exactly what I needed to do. Snapping was easy. I think the only camp building improvement that needs to be done is the blueprinting system, which desperately needs to be able to work in pretty much every area that you want to replace your camp in, because sometimes you'll move that camp, you'll pay the caps, and then find out that this area isn't too compatible with what you've got. And a lot of the times you're kind of going out on a limb, you know what your camp looks like, so you know this may or may not work. So I feel like that's the only aspect that does need some fixing, but other than that, I really enjoyed what was there for the camp, especially because it started off in Fallout 4 as just a settlement mode, and they expanded upon that with a bunch of DLC, a bunch of new items for that. It's like, how much further can you go with this? I wonder. I would love to see more quests built around the camp system. I actually think that would be an improvement to the camp itself, because a lot of the times it's just an option for players to hop into and spend their resources on. But I think it would be great if there were unique camp items that you unlocked through quests that you had to use to fulfill certain objectives that these quests required. Like I said, I think it would get the camp involved. I think it would spice up the gameplay loop a little bit away from the collect this or kill that or operate with this terminal, something along those lines. Now, I know I briefly discussed it in the beginning, but as for the much more section, I mean, that could be anybody's guess. I would love for it to be new locations if we could leave West Virginia and go somewhere else. I imagine that is absolutely being discussed and is under investigation by Bethesda Game Studios. You just have to wonder, with Fallout 76, the framework, the type of game it is, I imagine it's very well possible just based off pure inference, but I feel like I don't want to make too safe an assumption that we can go to new locations at some point in time. And if we were to go to a new location, what would it be? I feel like if they were to expand to a new area, it would be something like Fallout 3's Capital Wasteland. You know, I just feel like they're so close by and it's so possible that why not? Or we could go to the Commonwealth, or we could go to somewhere new like New York, which is an area that people have wondered about in Fallout for so many years. There are just so many opportunities to go to new locations, build the universe, make it feel alive, have a new purpose outside of West Virginia, and you're gradually rebuilding not just one part of the wasteland, but the entire wasteland. I know that they're saying they're planning on supporting Fallout 76 for years, so maybe this is a part of their launch roadmap. It's very different from Fallout 4, where we got our season pass in September before the game launched in November, and then I think it was sometime in February is when we actually got DLC plans from Bethesda. So it seems like with this one, they're just going to play by ear, since all DLC is going to be free with the game. And the lack of a official roadmap, I can't say surprises me, because we did see in the Fallout 76 documentary that they had this roadmap in place that they want to follow, but they don't know how much the game is going to break, what they're going to need to fix, how much that will set them back, or when will that roadmap actually go into effect. But since they have actually given us a list of updates that they're working on, I think maybe they worked out some of the kinks and bugs that a lot of us have been talking about. I mean, they don't mention other fixes like field of view or stash limits, which are things they covered on Reddit. So there's this weird difference on launch plans and beyond and fixes incoming for maybe launch itself. I imagine we're going to have a big day one patch, and that's where a lot of the issues that we had from the beta will be addressed, and then going forward they're just going to add new content to the game. I'm curious to see how quickly they're going to do that. That's the most important part of this game and the key to its continued success. I feel Fallout 76, despite what a lot of people are saying, is going to do well as a title. It's going to sell a ton. There's going to be a lot of people ready to support it. They need to get that content out fast, because people lose interest fast. You're going right up against Red Dead Online sometime at the end of this month. You need to keep people invested in your product, or at least make them feel like they have a tough choice between your product and the upcoming one. Just stay competitive. because if Bethesda can do holiday events and continuously add content at least on a monthly basis, I think they'll be in a safe spot. And I'm not asking for a bulk of quests each time, while that would be great, but I feel like if they stick to that and continuously update the game and give it a feeling of life and attention, and that it's not just some side project that they'll get to and just get some money off of, this game can be good for some Fallout fans. But that's pretty much all I have to say about this little update from Bethesda Game Studios. I'd love to hear your thoughts on their launch and beyond plans in the comments down below. Do you think they're going to some new locations? What do you think is going to happen with some of these vaults opening? Are you pumped about character respecking and a faction-based PvP system? Let's hear all about it in the comments down below. Do fire away. Other than that, follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook. Those links are in the description down below, along with my Patreon. Do consider supporting that, as it fuels all the content I create here. Stay sexy, stay active. I love you all. Peace.